In this tutorial, we will learn three statements: LET statement, input statement, and REM statement. So, what is REM statement? As you can see, I have already used REM statement here, or I have used one quote, single quote. Okay. Hope you have already seen my previous couple of videos where I have used it. And while I execute this program, and there was no impact of these line starting with REM. So what is the use of REM statement? REM stands for remark. Short form of remark is REM. REM adds comments in a program. Remarks are non-executable. As I mentioned in previous couple of tutorials, I have used this, and while I was executing, there was no impact of these remarks or non-executable statements. Then what is the use? It enhances the readability of the program code. It only appears in the programming code and has no effect on the output of the program, right? So REM, like I have used here, or single quote mark, is used to mark a statement as a comment. Whatever is written after a REM statement or single quote mark is ignored. We will see the example here. Okay. Now, what is LET? LET statement is used for assigning a value to a variable within a program whose value may change during the execution of the program. Okay. An input statement. Input statement is used to take input from the user during the program execution. Each input is stored in a separate variable. And there are two variables we have seen. There could be a character or string variable or numeric variable. For numeric variable, there is no used. We can directly assign. But when we are using alpha numeric or text variable, then we have to use dollar sign, right? So let's see how to use LET statement or input statement. So first I will show you the impact of REM and this single quote, whether it is executable or not. So I am printing VCG. Let's see. So we see there is a no impact, right? This is printing only VCG, correct? So we have covered this REM and single quote. Now LET and input. LET statement is used for assigning a value. So LET to a variable. We can have two variables, right? Let me use this age. Right, let's say I mention 14, and now I am, or I can say input. So I am asking what is your name. Okay. And then we'll create variable, because this is a alphanumeric variable. So when we will execute, the program will ask input, what is your name? So when we will enter the name, it will assign to this alphanumeric variable. Now what program will print? It will enter the name, right? So I am writing here name and then name variable, correct? And then we'll print age. So what will happen? Let is assigning the variable value. Done. We are taking inputs. What is your name? When we'll execute this program, the program will ask, enter input your name. Then we'll print this variable name, this variable, and then it will print age. Let's see. So it is line number 8 asking what is your name. So I can enter VCG knowledge channel, VCG knowledge channel 14. So why? After input VCG knowledge channel, it printed name VCG knowledge channel and then age, right? So this way we can use. There is a one more way. Let me, if I don't want to ask or input, then what I will do? Let what is your name, or let me remove this. It will also become a variable. And we have to enter here . So we have let assigning this value to this variable numeric, and this is a string assigning this, and then printing name and age, right? So we have covered let and print. Let's see, right? In the first example we saw the use of input, where program was asking while we executed that program, enter your name, right? Okay. Now what we will do, we will not be using LET now. We will use input. What we will do? Let me remove it from here. First we will ask input what is your name. It should be within quote. Okay. And then name and this. So it will ask input, and when we will enter the name, it will assign to this. Now second input, enter your contact number. Okay, here we will use number, and then we can remove this. And we'll print name. Name will come here, and then we'll print number. Right? So this is the third example. First example we see also the use of let and input. The second example we used let. The third example we are using input. There is some error. So we can see here input statement syntax error, line 7. Right? So we have to use here comma. Okay, now the error has gone. So we have covered this area as well, status. If there is an error, we can see here what is the error, right? Now execute. Now we can see it is asking after clearing screen, what is your name? So we can enter VCG. Knowledge channel, then enter your contact number. Okay, then 707123456. So name is VCG knowledge channel and number. So here we need to make one correction, and that correction is number. Here we can enter contact number, right? Or here we can use comma and then number. Here we have used semicolon, here we are using number. If there is any mistake, it will show you. Otherwise, we can execute. What is your name? ABC. Contact number 123456. Name is ABC. Contact number is 123456. Right? So, this is the way we can use input, print, let, and REM. That's all for this tutorial. Thank you very much.